You are empowering organizations to what? Deliver, to embed AI, but do it responsibly, do it proactively, monitor it, manage it. And I'm interested, Navrina, how many companies you think are actually holding back on interjecting generative AI because they are worried about some of the risks that are involved.
Thank you so much for having me. And what a critical topic right now. Carolyn, we are seeing across the industry right now, generative AI already reinventing businesses. The top of mind questions for many of our customers is, how can they continue innovating responsibly or get crushed by this generative AI wave? So right now, the top of mind question that we are hearing across our customers and partners is, how can I adopt generative AI confidently and responsibly to make sure that the risks like copyright, IP leakage, plagiarism, et cetera, are under check?
Your background is fascinating because you're building this way of monitoring and doing it responsibly. You used to be a director of product over at Microsoft, thinking about the ways in which AI can be commercialized. Is corporate America at this moment being thoughtful enough? Is VC, private money, being thoughtful enough about the guardrails that need to go in place at the same time as the exuberance around just the innovation?
You know, Carolyn, there is some momentum, but it needs to be more. As you can imagine, now it's not about just winning with AI. It is also about how you win with AI. And this is where we are going to start seeing a lot of differentiation among organizations that actually emerge as leaders in this age of AI. Where there is investment in AI governance, where there is investment in oversight, where there is investment in not only understanding AI risks, but managing them at scale, while also keeping an eye out to future regulation. That's where we are going to see the wins emerging in this ecosystem. So AI governance is certainly underfunded and certainly, becoming top of mind, but we need to see more progress and momentum in this space.
Navrina, good morning to you. Government compliance, doing business with the public sector. What level of government compliance does Credo have? Are you able to offer your services to the federal government as an example?
Absolutely, Ed. So recently we announced a very strong partnership with Booz Allen with exactly that focus. As you can imagine, there's been an emerging discussion in White House around how do you, make sure that frameworks like Bill of Rights are implemented appropriately across U.S. agencies so that we are always keeping, U.S. citizens' rights central to this conversation. So Credo AI right now is working across United States government, as well as with partners like Booz Allen, so that we can bring AI governance as a mechanism for them to accelerate AI adoption, but do so, again, safely and responsibly.
Navrina, there's a debate within the artificial intelligence community, AI native or AI adjacent startup founders basically looking at regulation and saying, well, if we think about healthcare or education, those are highly regulated industries where the consumer faces high prices or there are still risks in place. What is the benefit of focusing on a commercial guardrail versus seeking comprehensive regulation?
Yeah, Ed, I think this is where we have to really strike a right balance between innovation and regulation that supports that innovation. And, there's global initiatives that I'm actually actively involved in, Credo AI is involved in, again, to make sure that AI governance and oversight across the entire value chain, from design, development, to procurement and use of AI systems happen. And so, this is an opportunity for us to really bring in private and public sector together to ensure that policy goes hand in hand with innovation so that it can become an accelerant rather than a deterrent to this AI innovation.